We're going to talk about how to graph the function 2x squared plus 3 divided by x minus 1 times x plus 1 from work that's already been done using calculus to find out information about this function. So let's look at what information we have. We have determined that the domain is all real numbers except for 1 and negative 1, so we could write that as negative infinity to negative 1. Union, negative 1 to 1, union, 1 to infinity. And now we've checked it for symmetry and determined that it has even symmetry, which means it's symmetric across the y-axis. We've calculated the first and second derivatives and used these to find critical points and possible inflection points. Our critical points are occurring at 0, 1, and negative 1. And our possible inflection points are occurring at negative 1 and 1. Now we've created f prime and f double prime number lines based on these critical points and possible inflection points. And the first thing I would like us to do if we're going to try to graph these functions is redraw these number lines so that they are occurring directly underneath of our graph. And we're going to do this because it's going to allow us to line up the information that we need about our graph. So this first line will be f prime, second line will be f double prime, and since the interesting things in this graph seem to be happening at negative 1 and 1, I'm going to actually make the scale be that this point is 1, this point is negative 1. So directly underneath here, I'm going to label these same places on my f prime and f double prime number lines, so that I have negative 1, 0, and 1 lined up with my graph. And now, just translating over what's on the previous page, on f prime we have plus, plus, minus, minus, and on f double prime we have plus, minus, plus. Now we've also determined there is a local maximum value at when x is 0, and at that point is actually 0, 3. So let's go ahead and graph that on our graph as well. One of the big things to keep in mind when you're doing graphing based on all these computations is that anything with a predetermined y value, you're going to want to write down first. So this is a point that we have that has a y value. Now the next thing it says we have vertical asymptotes at x equals 1 and x equals negative 1. And so we can go ahead and draw those in, but that's just actually a start, knowing where the vertical asymptotes should be, because we also need to know the actual limits on either side of a vertical asymptote. Because remember, a vertical asymptote, to determine a vertical asymptote, that's where you take a limit towards a constant and you get either infinity or negative infinity. That's the definition. And so to figure out how this graph behaves, we need to actually compute these limits. So let's go to the next page. Really, we probably should have done this earlier when we were saying where the vertical asymptotes were. So we need to find the limit as x goes to 1 from the positive side of our function, and our function was 2x squared plus 3 divided by x minus 1 times x plus 1. And when we go to evaluate this limit, we do determine that we get 5 over 0, so we get a non-zero number divided by 0 as our form. That tells us that we have a vertical asymptote. But now we need to determine the sign, because if we have a vertical asymptote and we're coming from the right or the left, remember that that means our answer is either infinity or negative infinity, but we have to figure out which one. So we look at the signs. The top is 5, so it's positive. The bottom, as a number bigger than 1 minus 1, is going to give us a positive number. And a number bigger than 1 plus 1 is going to give us a positive number. So these are all positive. This is a positive infinity. And what that means for our graph is if we're approaching 1 from the right side, we're going up. Now if we take the limit as x goes to 1 from the left of our function, we're still going to get 5 over 0. But now we need to again determine the sign of that infinity. So this time we're going to get a positive number on top, divided by a number less than 1 minus 1 is a negative number, and then a number just less than 1 plus 1 is a positive number. So we get a positive over a negative times a positive, that's a negative. So we get negative infinity. So that means if we're approaching 1 from the left side, we're going to be going down. And notice how I put these little arrows on my graph. This helps me remember what's going on at these asymptotes. Similarly, I take the limit as x goes to 1, negative 1, from the right side of 2x squared plus 3 over x minus 1 times x plus 1. And this one also is going to give us 5 over 0. So let's determine the signs. The top is still positive. The bottom is something a little bigger than negative 1 minus 1. So negative minus a negative is going to be a negative. And then something a little bigger than negative 1 plus 1. So here's negative 1 on the number line. We're bigger than that. And if we add 1 to it, then we're going to be positive. So this is positive over negative times positive, so this is a negative infinity. So if we're going to negative 1 from the right side over here, you get a negative infinity. And then the last thing to compute is the limit as x goes to negative 1 from the left side, 2x squared plus 3 divided by x minus 1, x plus 1. Equals positive on top, and you have a negative number minus a negative number, so negative something less than negative 1 minus 1, that's going to be negative. And then you have something less than minus 1 plus 1, so their number line again, here's negative 1, here's 0. Now we're less than negative 1, so adding 1 is we're not going to still quite get to 0 yet, so it's still going to be negative. So a positive over a negative times a negative is positive infinity. So on our graph, that means if we're to the left of negative 1, we're going up. All right, so that's all of our vertical asymptote information. Let's see what we determined about the horizontal asymptotes. Here it says, as x goes to infinity, we get 2. And as x goes to negative infinity, we get 2. So we can go ahead and draw those on as well. 2 is right here. So it's going to look like this. Now notice, though, that I don't make this horizontal asymptote go all the way across. That's because I don't want to confuse myself, because you can cross a horizontal asymptote. And sometimes if I put those dotted lines in, I start thinking like I can't. And then we do have some points here that we can plot as well. So we know that there are no x-intercepts, but we have a y-intercept at negative 3. Well, that's the point we've already plotted. So I guess those are all of our points and all of our asymptotes. So that's all the information about the height of the graph, the y-values, how far up and down on this graph I should actually put my function. And now I'm going to look at the way the function is curving. So from negative infinity to negative 1, I know f prime is positive, so it's increasing. And I know that f double prime is positive, so it's part of a smiley face. So the way I combine those two things, it tells me that my graph has to look like this. Has to look like a curve of this type. And in fact, we can actually classify all the kinds of curves. So we can say, depending on, you know, if f prime is positive or f prime is negative, and if f double prime is positive or if f double prime is negative, exactly what your curve has to look like. So if f prime is positive and f double prime is positive, it's increasing concave up like this. That's what we just said. If f prime is negative but f double prime is positive, it's the other half of the smiley face, decreasing concave up. If f prime is positive but f double prime is negative, it's the increasing part of the frowny face. And if f prime is negative and f double prime is negative, it's the decreasing part of the frowny face. So putting that over here on our graph, from negative 1 to 0, we should be increasing but concave down. So that means we should look like this. And when you're graphing these, make sure your lines have enough of a little bubble to them. This computer keeps wanting to straighten them out. That doesn't have any concavity at all. So now from 0 to 1, we are decreasing and concave down, so we look like this. And from 1 to infinity, we are decreasing and concave up, so it looks like this. Now notice that what I just did there, the technique, the reason I put these number lines underneath this graph, is so I could read from left to right, and any time I hit any hash mark on either number line, I stopped and I made a new kind of arc. So now we're going to play connect the dots with our kinds of arcs. So all the way over here at the left, we have, so going off the screen, approaching negative infinity, we're approaching negative 2, and then we're going increasing and concave up to approach this asymptote going to infinity. And then from negative 1 to 0, we are going to negative infinity as we approach the negative 1 asymptote. And at 0, we're supposed to be at negative 3. Like I said, 3 earlier, but that was actually a typo. So we should be approaching, going from negative 3 and drawing an arc that is increasing but concave down and going down to this asymptote. And then when x is 0 to x is 1, we are decreasing, concave down, and approaching the asymptote at 1. And then from 1 to infinity, we are connecting these last two arrows with a curve which is decreasing and concave up. And there we are, we've sketched our graph.